So in today's video, I'm going to share with you how easy it is to create your own landing page on your WordPress website. Are you ready? Let's go. Okay, so let's take a real quick look at Jazmin's landing page for her book release. So at the top, you'll see she has a nice little coming soon announcement. And then she's using a really neat feature, which is a countdown timer. I use these all the time. I absolutely love them. The really cool thing two is you can set them for a certain day and time. And once that day and time arrives, your visitors will be redirected to a new page. Let's say you have an online course sales page and the day and time that it ends, let's say tomorrow at midnight. Once that time arrives, your visitors and that promo or that course is no longer available, you can have visitors redirected to a new landing page saying enrollment has closed and maybe offering them something else instead. So it's really, really great. I love it. As we scroll down, she added in the middle a nice little opt-in so that she can send people the first 16 pages of her book before it releases. In the center is a cute little quote, and at the bottom are some features. So as you can see, there's nothing too complicated here. It's very clean and very simple. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you exactly how we created this. And I'm going to use our motivational coach website. If you love this website, it's available for purchase on my website, and I can include a link for you down below. I'm going to show you exactly how to create a landing page on your WordPress website. And I have my motivational coach website pulled up. And if you're interested in purchasing this website, I'll include a link below where you can go ahead and grab it. And let's do this. So in order to get started, we make sure we're logged into our website. And then we're going to go ahead and click on new page right from the top of our WordPress site. All right, the first thing we're going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and give this a title. I'm going to call it landing page for simplicity's sake. Over on the right-hand side, there's a few things we want to make sure we disable. We want to disable the primary header. This will get rid of the logo and the navigation. Disable the title, a featured image, the footer bar. We just want to get rid of everything, and we just want a clean, empty page with nothing on it. So we're going to get rid of all that stuff. All right, and if that looks good, I'm going to go back up and I'm just going to publish it for now. Okay, so that you guys can see it. So I, as you know, if you've been following me for a while, I use a page builder called Beaver Builder to create amazing pages on the fly. So what we're going to do is we're going to use this nice little button here, Launch Beaver Builder, which will take us to the front side of our website. And here we go. So if this is the first time you're using Beaver Builder, you can take a tour. They'll show you around. We've used it before, so we're going to say no thanks. Now you'll notice the top, everything is gone from the top. There's no primary navigation. There's no headers. It's just a clean page. Now you do see this gray area, so we're going to get rid of that. I'll have to go back and show you how to do that. And then at the bottom, so we are using a theme, Astro theme, which has been customized. And this is a section that has been added to the bottom. So we'll have to turn that off as well. So there's a couple of things to turn off, but that's not really a big deal. So over on the right-hand side to get started, we are going to drop a row in here. So if we look at our page, it has a nice little coming soon at the top. So what we're gonna do is just do a one column row. And inside that, so then we're going to click on the modules and we're going to grab a heading and we'll drop a heading in there and we're just going to type in coming soon. I've got a lot of cords here in my way. Coming soon. Oops. And we'll go ahead and style that up. We are going to make it centered. Very nice. And that's good. Okay. Now you'll notice that we want this row. So this is our row. We want our row to go clear across the page. So we're going to make that full width. and the content can stay in the center. Now, there is a nice background she has on that. So down where it says background, we're going to pick color. And we're going to make that a pretty color. So our options are for this website are this pink and black color. So I'm going to make that pink. Now, the black is not looking amazing. So we're going to make our text white. And there we go. Now, I'll click save. Now, one thing I do want to do right now is I'm going to go back to our edit our page. So I'm going to click on edit page. I'm going to go back and I'm going to set this page to full width. So over where it says Astra settings, again, Astra is the name of the theme, and I'll leave a link to that as well for you. There's no sidebar. We have that turned off, but right here where it says content layout, we want to use full width and stretch. That will take up our whole page and there won't be any colored background. So let's make sure we have that and we'll update it. She's got this countdown timer in the middle. So we're gonna go to module and we can just take our timer. Okay, so you can see here's the countdown. Now, it doesn't look like hers. That's because she has customized it and you can, customize it. Now, the really cool thing about this timer is you can do a fixed timer. You can also do one for evergreen. So in the future, if you ever have something that you want evergreen, this is great for that too. But for now, we're doing fixed. We're going to do our time zone. You just can pick one here. Now select your date and time. So this is when you want it to end. We're going to go with, we're just going to pick a date for fun. And then you can even do up to the hour and the minutes. So we'll just pick some minutes here. Okay. So there's our time. And we can choose an action for after the timer ends. So we can hide the timer, we can display a message, or we can direct our user to a new URL or do nothing. So those are your choices. And the styling is fun. So you can choose how much space you want between the timer. You can space between the elements. We can change the digits. We can make it circle, square, or a custom. We can add a background color. So you can see there's a lot of things we can do here. The border style. We can choose to put our units inside the box. And we can move them above or below. Okay. There's a lot more here. Now you can turn on, if you want to turn year, we're going to turn off years because there's no years. We're going to turn off the months. We just want the days, hours, minutes, and seconds counting down. So there's that. And I'm going to go back up because there, it looks a little better. It was a little bit big. Okay. That looks better. And then for our topography, you can go in here and we can make that a different size. Different size. That's our font. We can, our units, we can dial that back a little bit. We want to make those smaller. Okay. And you can change the color. Okay. So I think you have the idea there. So I'm going to move on. Now, looking back at the coming soon page, we see that she has a book on the left and her text on the right. So real quick, we're going to drop in a row with two columns. And we're going to add the left, the book. Now we need to upload the file. Okay, there's that. And then I'm going to put a heading on the right, and her heading is here. We can just copy that. and paste it in. And you'll see here that it's kind of wrapping around. So we'll want to change that. Like over here on our row, we can make this row go full width. And then our content, we can actually make that go full width. And so we can move this around. You can really customize it a lot. We're gonna move it back in. I think that looks good. Now, another little trick is you can see how this is kind of above this. We can center these columns so that they're equal. So we wanna equalize our heights and we'll just center them. Now this will change once I add the text. So I'll go back up. I'm gonna drag my text editor over here. And we're gonna copy this text and paste it in. There, like that. And hit save. So that looks really nice. And we can do a little bit more here. Yeah. Okay, that looks really, really good. Now, you can see there's a big space right here between these two things. I wanna move this row up. So I just click on the row gear and I head over here to advanced. And the padding, I can make that 0 and that will move that up a little bit. Yeah, looks good. And then same thing you can do for this row. You can go here and we can make that 0. We don't want that at the top. There, so you can see the spacing is a little bit better there. Okay, so can you see how we're starting to get our landing page to take shape? One more thing I wanna share with you before we go is I wanna show you that opt-in right here in the center. That's a really neat feature. Let's go here. And down here is what's called a subscription form. It makes it super easy to add a subscription box to your website. Here is our opt-in box. You can choose your service. And as you can see here, you can choose from Active Campaign, ConvertKit, MailerLite, MailerChimp, Infusionsoft. I mean, there's Entreport, there's Constant Contact. So yeah, there's tons of them to choose from. You'll just need to create an account name that's unique to your company, the API key, which you will find at your email service provider, and then you click connect, and they'll connect. And then from there, it's super easy to customize this. You enter a heading, you can add a subheading below, your form fields, your name, email provider. You can add some more custom text below. Let's say you want to have them check a box for terms and conditions. You can show that for GDPR. So as you can see, there's all kinds of ways that you can customize this. Additionally, there's the styling. The button can be customized. So you'll see that we'll click save. Now you'll notice on ours, it's a lot smaller. So we just go over to the row and we'll just make that row smaller, like 900. And click save. And then you can also customize the column so that you can add like a background color behind this. And let's just go like that for now. So you can see how easy it is to get, there, like that. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below, send me an email. I would love to hear from you. Take care, guys. Bye. Hey guys, my name is Jennifer Franklin and I want to welcome you to my YouTube channel. Each week, I'll bring you a brand new video, so be sure to hit that subscribe button and leave me a comment below. See you later.